much for joining us. Hey, Lisa, how you doing?
Thanks for having me again.
Good to see you today on this Monday. Hey, we want to jump into this with you here. There's been talk about this being a huge day. There is a state of emergency declared by Governor Northam in that area, preparing for what could have been the worst. No reports of injuries, no reports of arrests. Mm-hmm. What are your opinions on this?
I take my hat off to Governor Northam for preparing for the worst, which is cool, because we know what happened in Virginia a long time ago, about 2-3 years ago, where people were having a peaceful rally and things went to the left and went wrong. People had guns and drove over people, shot at people, and harmed people just because they had a difference of opinion. But I would like to say I'm so sick of the NRA gaslighting the gun control situation, like this gentleman that was on, I think his name was Alex. First of all, no one's taking guns from anybody. Megan McCain says that all the time. Are you gonna take our guns? If you own a legal gun, no one's gonna knock at your door and say, hey, I'm here to take your guns. That's number one. So that's gaslighting. Number two, I don't think the legislation is ridiculous at all. I think it's very fair. First of all, when you look at the Second Amendment is for you to bear arms for the sole purpose of you to protect yourself in your home, self-defense in your home. Why would a person in their home need an assault rifle? Why would a person in their home need 15 and 20 handguns? From what I understand, the legislation is saying we're going to ban assault rifles, which I agree with, but we're going to allow you to have a handgun and you can buy a handgun a month. So let's do the math, shall we? A handgun a month multiplied times 12 months of a year, you can have 12 handguns a year. So let me see. When the burglar breaks into your house, are you going to go, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, which gun should I use to shoot you in the head while you're robbing my house? You're not gonna think that way. The minute someone breaks into your home, you're just gonna grab the gun and try to shoot the person so that you can defend yourself. You're not gonna sit there and pull out all your guns and pick based on the color codes which one to use while the person's robbing you. So like, those things are unnecessary. You don't need 15 and 20 guns. So that's, to me, very reasonable. Listen, I don't own a gun. I'm too scared to shoot somebody in the head. But I do believe in the Second Amendment. I believe in the right to bear arms for the sole purpose of protecting you and your family. I think it's totally okay to do that with a handgun, or two, or three, or 12.
Lisa, there's a number of laws that are already in place. And you know, if you go and look at the Second Amendment, it doesn't say you can only have this amount of guns. So I think a lot of folks are saying, like, I should be able to have as many firearms as I choose.
But it does say, specifically in the language, that you have the right to bear arms to protect yourself. So like, if we're thinking, even when, like, although I don't agree with it, but let's say, for example, you smacked me, we were standing here and you smacked me. I just can't shoot you because you smacked me. That's called excessive force, right? So let's be honest here. You don't need 15 guns to protect yourself if a person broke into your home, or you were being assaulted inside of your home. You just need one gun with a few bullets in there. Do you want 5 guns in your hand and start shooting them at the same time? I mean, how would you even use 12 guns when a person breaks into your home? You don't need that to protect yourself. So like, that's just common sense, you know? So all of these things in the Constitution are commonsensical kinds of rights. So this is a game they're playing. They're playing reindeer games. You just want a bunch of guns because you're nuts. Now let's talk about, you want a bunch of guns because you just like seeing a bunch of guns. Gun collectors, I think, is a totally different thing. Like, art collectors have more art than I do. So that's another lane. Now let's talk about mental health. It's a myth that most people who have mental illness are killing people. Most people who are using those guns in a negative way are people who are just evil individuals, who are crimeful individuals, not people with mental health issues. But certainly I'm okay with this legislation making sure that they look through all of those kinds of things. That's how I feel about it.